This review has been made possible by Chevrolet of Naperville. As you know, Chevy has tons of brand new cars and trucks available for purchase, but did you know that they also have a remarkable selection of used cars? Head on over to ChevroletOfNaperville.com and look through hundreds of used cars for sale right now. What's up, guys? My name is Zach, and today I am driving a 2007 Pontiac Solstice. Up front is a 2.4 liter inline four, and down below is a 5-speed automatic transmission. Now, I am super excited to be driving this here Solstice because I think that they're very unique. I think they're very special, and just in my short time driving it, both have been the case. And we'll talk about why that is throughout the rest of this video. But if you guys would like to support me, I have my website, zachpradel.com, where you can buy merch. I have stickers available right now, as well as you can read my blog. I give a behind the scenes look of what cars I'm filming, as well as you could submit your vehicle. There is a submission form if you'd like me to review your car. You can also email me at pradelreviews@gmail.com if you'd like to submit your vehicle that way. But let's get back to that 2.4 liter inline four under the hood. It is an Ecotec engine shared with the Pontiac G6. And the reason I bring that up is because that was one of my cars back in the day, and I put 160,000 miles on that car. So I know these Ecotec engines pretty well. This one makes 177 horsepower and 166 foot-pounds of torque, which is pretty good. Now, like I said, I took my G6 with the 2.4 all the way up to 193,000 miles. And honestly, the engine never really gave me too much trouble. The cam position sensor kept going out a couple of times, but I got so fed up with it, I went 40,000 miles with the check engine light on for the cam position sensor, and nothing ever happened to the engine. So these are little stout things. Another thing I want to note is the fact that you could get these with a 2-liter turbo. The GXPs came with a 2-liter turbo out of the Chevy Cobalt SS. Like I said, paired to it, 5-speed automatic transmission. Again, nothing crazy here. However, you could find these in manual if that's something you'd like, and that's something I'd highly recommend. Last but not least, this is rear wheel drive, and we'll talk a little bit more about that with the final thoughts, because it's actually a Cadillac CTS-V diff at the back. Well, really, the Cadillac CTS-V gets a Pontiac Solstice diff. So there you have it. With that out of the way, let's talk about the interior. Well, in front of me, I have two gauges. On the left is my speedometer. On the right is my tachometer. And in the center, I do get a little fuel gauge. On the steering wheel on the left, I have my cruise control options, as well as my page option for the little odometer screen. I can get a couple other pieces of information. And on the right, I have my volume, skip track, and phone options. This is the same steering wheel as the Pontiac G6 or the C6 Corvette, if you're more into those. And then on the left, I have a little vent, and on the door, I have my lock and unlock power mirrors and power windows. I'll talk about those in a second. Moving into the center, I have my hazard switch, fog light switch, and dimmer switch, and then I have two climate control vents and the climate controls themselves. This whole center console really starts to swoop towards the driver, really reminds me of either an FD RX-7 or a Toyota Supra Mark IV. I have the very typical radio that was put into every single GM product from this era, nothing too crazy there, and a 12 volt outlet down below that. The shifter is numb, however, it's an automatic shifter. They pulled this from some parts bin, and it's not that interesting. The center console itself has nothing on it. I'd get a parking brake, but then I just have a spot to rest my arm. The cup holders are actually behind me and actually pop out of the center. And with those cup holders, they have no hope of holding the big friggin' bottle. So the Solstice fails the big friggin' bottle test. I also have a little cubby and the Pontiac logo up at the top. The seats are nice and comfortable. They are finished in black leather, and I'm pleasantly enjoying them. That's what's in the interior, but now I want to talk about the interior itself and the fact that I don't think whoever designed the dimensions was a human. And you might be thinking, Zach, you're a big guy and you're just complaining that it's a small car. And it is a small car, but that's not what I mean. Everything in here is very oddly proportioned. What I mean by that is that the door smashes me in. I don't really have much left leg room. That's fine, okay. Pretty typical for little roadsters. Then we have this giant open space for my right arm. Nothing there, kind of weird. And the cup holders are positioned behind me. How am I supposed to comfortably grab a cup? I guess like this? And then same with the window switches. The window switches are back here, so I have to basically elbow my own seat in order to find that. And the door handle is way up high. So I'm being squished, but also there's too much room. It's very, very weird because it's a small car and it feels small to drive. It's nimble like it's small. But then there's these weird spaces. Very interesting. I don't know. Let's go take a quick look at the trunk.
All right, so we're on the back of the Pontiac Solstice, and you might be thinking, Zach, how do you pop the trunk? There's no buttons here. It looks nice and smooth. That's because there is no buttons there. So to pop the trunk, you have to go into the car, go into the glove box, and hit, there's a little trunk release button. And that pops these up, these like little feet, and then you can pull the trunk actually up. It's a rear hinged trunk, which is very weird. And once you're in here, you have pretty much no space. Not great. Here's the thing, opening the trunk should not be that many steps. I should be able to hit a button or put my key into the back and it pops up. There's no reason for it to be rear hinged like this. This is very dumb. This is very stupid. And then you close it, and I've never closed a trunk and then had additional things I had to do. Not only do I have to come around to this one, but then I have to walk around here. Then I have to do this one. There, now the trunk is finally closed. I'm not complaining about walking 6 feet. I'm complaining that I have to walk 6 feet no matter what. That is stupid.
Now we gotta talk about the looks. And there's a very, very interesting story that goes into the looks of this car. But first of all, before we get to that, I want to talk about this platform. Because this was not only sold as the Pontiac Solstice, but it was also sold as the Saturn Sky, the Opel GT, and if I can ever find one of these, I would film it in a heartbeat, a Daewoo G2X in Asia. They made a Daewoo version of this, which is so cool. Daewoos, you don't even see anymore, let alone I didn't know that they made a version of the Solstice as a Daewoo. But this is a very interestingly designed car, and it was actually a collaboration between three different designers. First of all, we have our Lord and Savior Wayne Cherry, responsible for designing the Suburban and Tahoe and Silverado from the 90s into the 2000s. I think they are some of the best looking trucks ever. I've ranted and raved about Wayne Cherry in many other reviews. I love his work. It was also partially designed by Vicky Vlachakis, and I apologize if I mispronounced that. She was also responsible for designing the Chevy SS's interior for the concept. And it was also designed by Franz von Holzhausen, who later went on to Mazda to design the Mazda Furii concept car, the one that burned down on Top Gear, and then left Mazda and went on to design every single Tesla product besides the original Roadster. So he designed the Model S, the Model 3, the Model X, the Model Y, the Cybertruck, the Semi, and the second gen Tesla Roadster, as well as he was the guy that threw the steel ball at the Cybertruck and shattered the window. So, kind of an interesting trio there. All right, I apologize if it now sounds windy in here. I turned the heat on because I'm going to open the top and it is, can I get a current outside temperature, please? Okay, I don't get any readouts in here to tell me that. But just believe me, last I checked, it was 12 degrees. Okay, I have to now Google this. I have found a YouTube video. Thank you to Neighborhood Car Reviews. Shout out to you. I have to watch an ad, which is great for neighborhood car reviews, but I feel like as a content creator, I should get YouTube Red for free. But okay, so set the parking brake, undo the lever, hit the trunk release button inside the glove box. Hold on, video, stop. Okay, I have to rearrange this because now I have to get out of the car. Never have I ever reviewed a convertible where I had to get out of the car to just lower the roof. All right, so I'm supposed to raise this up. Okay, do that. Come around the other side. And then fold it in like that. Oh, that doesn't seem right. Okay. Oh yeah, he just pushes it down. Okay. I don't want to force it. It doesn't. So, now the trunk won't close. There's a helicopter above. Can you hear it? They're coming for me. That is so stupid. for the convertible top. The reason I say that is because every other convertible I've ever driven either A, has a power top, but B, I'm not even asking for a power top. I own a Miata. The manual top was fine, but it worked and I could do it from right here at least. Dumb. Dumb.
Now I will say they did make a coupe version of the Solstice. However, they are incredibly rare, super low production numbers, but I have to imagine that that convertible top trunk situation was fixed with the coupe. I hope. I am praying. If anyone has a coupe, Solstice, or Sky that I could review, please email me. I would love to get out there and film it.
Here's the thing. I like the Pontiac Solstice because it is so weird and strange, and it's something that I can't really quite see happening again. Maybe as an EV, but to me, this car is like that road trip or that sleepover you had with your friends when you were still young and dumb. Let me elaborate. This car is a concoction of so many different things. If we just want to talk about the parts, the rear axle and differential is from the CTS. The passenger side airbag, steering column, and exterior door handles are from a Chevy Cobalt. The backup lights are from a GMC Envoy. The heating and ventilation system is from a Hummer H3. The fog lights are from a Pontiac Grand Prix. The steering wheel is from a Pontiac G5, Chevy Corvette, and Cobalt. The engine is from the G6 and Chevy HHR. The manual transmission, if I were to get one, is the same as the H3 Hummer or GMC Canyon. And the 5-speed automatic, which is in this car, is the same from the Cadillac CTS and STS. And like I mentioned, it was manufactured under a couple of different names. Pontiac, Saturn, Daewoo, and Opel, of which one remains. So you have all these different parts coming together to form this one car. And it was cool, unique, and interesting, and different, and fun, and I was excited to wake up this morning and drive a Pontiac Solstice. Jazz from the Transformers movie. But then the gang split up. The designers went on to design vastly different things, from full-size Chevy trucks to little electric cars. Pontiac and Saturn, here in the States, no longer exist after 2009. And as with every good vacation trip or sleepover you have with your friends, there's someone that tries to recreate it. That's right. When GM went bankrupt in 2009, they decided to sell off the Wilmington, Delaware plant where these were built. And so a company came to the table and said, yes, we drew up this concept. We would like to make the Solstice under our own name. And GM said, oh, well, what name would that be? And they replied, DeLorean. The new DeLorean Motor Company, responsible for remanufacturing with new old stock DeLoreans, wanted to buy the rights to the Solstice and make the DeLorean Solstice. I'm not kidding you. Jalopnik wrote a whole article about it. That was the plan, and unfortunately it fell through. So they ended up selling the plant to another interesting company, Fisker, who made the Fisker Karma and is now making a rebound with Fisker Electrics. And so, at the end of the day, something like this can't really happen again. It's just like that famous road trip. You look back on it fondly, it might have been one of the best times of your life. But those days are in the past, and the future looks vastly different. But for that initial 2006 to 2010 run of the Pontiac Solstice, they created something truly unique and interesting. There's just some things about this car that really irritate me, even though the memories of it are so good. That convertible top is annoying to put up and down, and the reason I complain about it so much is because that is crucial. So many times was I driving my Miata with the top down, and it starts raining out of nowhere, and I toss it up. I lean over, pull the top up, latch it twice. It's up in about 10 seconds. And same with down. I'm driving, it's maybe a cold day, I want to put the top down with the heat on. Bada bing, bada boom. This, you have to pull over in a Jewel Osco parking lot and get out. And today the car's covered in salt because this is January. And now I had to lean on the car, so now my jacket has salt all over it. It's just so much added headache when so many other cars do it so much better. And that's why I complained so much about it. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Huge thank you to Chevy of Naperville for letting me take out their Pontiac Solstice. This thing is so flipping cool. I'm very thankful that they have one of these on the lot. Please go check them out. They have Camaros and Corvettes and this Solstice right here. So please go check them out. Their information is up on the screen as well as found in the description below. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Don't forget to rate the video, comment on the video, and subscribe if you really liked it. Take care, guys. Thank you.